Hey guys, Rewind here. Today we're going to be playing something a bit different than usual. I finally managed to get a DS emulator to work, so we're going to be playing Dawn of Sorrow. Since an emulator is the only way I've got to record the damn thing. Okay, anyway. Happened. The power of dominance. I love it. I just like how it sounds. Yes, you lost your. You apparently lost his power, but you get this terrible feeling. It's probably nothing. Don't worry, in the past year I haven't been able to use any of the powers I gained. The powers of every single monster soul in the previous game. Ah, look, it's the local villain. Celia Fortin, head of a cult. Never says which cult. You may call me this, but not for long. So she goes and summons some monsters. And Mina goes, ah! And then Barrio. Arricardo! Arricardo. Guess who that is? Barrio. Quicksilver, catch this knife. It's rusty and made them kind of rubbish. A cheap pocket knife that cuts poorly. And my regular clothes, which consist of a badass coat. So, we have our dead souls. Thank you. see my mind, that's certain, using whatever means.
Sure.
Yeah, I won't be able to catch her because she teleported to somewhere. I'm fine, the power returns. Didn't return, it was always working. Shut up, wherever you are. Yeah. Power didn't return, you know, I've never had need of it since I fled the castle. I mean, that's it for you all the time. Hey look, it's a cheap excuse for why I don't have any of my special powers from the previous game. Well, most of them. What was that woman? That's Celia Foot. Rapidly growing cult. Yes, she's the priestess of a rapidly growing cult that we see about three members of throughout the entire game. Up to something, because she wants my powers, Dragon's reincarnation. Don't worry about that, I didn't become the Lord of Darkness. Yeah, at the end of the last game I was given the choice of, do I become the Lord of Darkness or not? And I chose not to, because I could, pretty much. I intend to create a new world by eliminating me. Don't you get any more involved with this? Let us deal with it. You and your mysterious shadowy organization. My response is, oh, hell no! See my demise. Yes. 2 weeks later. No, several days. I've found my way to this place. Having asked Hammer, the goof. I get here and I immediately start doubting his information. That's Hammer. He sells weapons. And that's about it. Yes, I doubted your word. Because your information hasn't been accurate for a long time now. What are you doing here? He came here to told me about this place, so he came here because he wants to set up another shop. Quite how he expects to do good business in a deserted castle building thing. You go, you might not do something wicked, huh? I want in. Oh yeah, and he likes Yoko, descendant of a previous Castlevania main character. She's not coming, haven't told a soul. Since I'm here, I'd better make the best of it. I guess I'm back in business. Yes, I'm his only customer. He really should leave, but he's not going to. About the area. Yes, I'm not too sure how he manages to get from here to where he sets up shop, given that there's a boss room in the way and a whole load of monsters. Admittedly, we've never seen him fight either, but... Well, I wouldn't just tell her about this, because I barely know her, and... Actually, that's about it, really. Anyway, let's have some good music. You don't get souls every time you kill something, it's just a... It's a random chance thing. If I were to go... Okay. Yeah, see, like, that one's got a rarity of 3 stars, so I'm almost never going to get it. Better weapon? Oh! cutscene. Yes, it's Yoko and Julius. Yeah, you got wind of the book on the tip, blah blah blah, and this will be the Belmont. The darkness draws you in, I have no choice but to destroy you. Sure thing, Mothman. No reason for me to be here. Oh yeah? She didn't really try to harm me, though. She summoned a skeleton in front of you, and then you stabbed it. And she summoned, Armor Knight, and then you stabbed her. And then she summoned a golem, and you stabbed it several times. On the turn, I don't know what to say. And Julius just goes, screw this noise. No, you stay here, because, reasons. Yeah, Julius just shows how badass he is by jumping that. No, I don't have any intention of going here. Take this. You give me a magic seal. Yeah, this is the gimmick of this game. The magic seal system is irritating at times. I suspect it'll be harder with using mouse for control. Gates that draw the power of darkness. Monsters are invincible. I use the seal to close the gate so I can actually kill the invincible monsters. If that makes sense to you, well done! So it's like a level 1 seal. So on. One more thing, practice drawing in the time, not sure how, don't we practice. I don't see archives on its own, it's needed. Let's go! Dead end, yeah. Only Julius can get in the toilets. Right now. That will change. Go find a different room. Oh, Charlotte here. Yes, sure. Despite the fact that you can probably kick more ass than I can right now, I will escort you.
Already
got a figure on just how challenging this guy is in the start level of equipment. There we go. And then... yeah, if you take too much time to draw a magic seed, it goes hell no. And... the enemy gets brought back with a certain amount of health here. When it's something like 10% of our total health. Probably got it wrong where they hacked it, so you only need to draw the first line. Anyway, there we go. So, kill him, get another soul, but the bosses, they always drop a soul. Because they're going to fight the boss once until the game. Da-da-da-da-da, I did it. Got magic seal. Da-da-da-da-da. Probably prepare better, more complex seals. Hey look, a justification for it. Yes, you can manage from now, because on the path between here and where you're setting up, there are no enemies. One more thing, Julius may have information, come see me if you're close by. Don't do anything reckless. Grab that thing. Here's where Yoko set up shop. Quite literally. Yeah, there you go, I just contact here, no one living here, so you moved in. Oh yeah, Hammer's living across the road. What's he doing here? He came to help. I didn't ask him to come, no. It's too dangerous for him to be here, can't you tell him to leave? I already did. Didn't work. It's hopeless, especially since you're here. She gained a new ability. That worked well with my ability, conveniently. Since I have the ability to take control of enemy souls, she has gained the ability to use them and fuse them with weapons. Da 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 da, bloody bloody blah. She's an exceptional spellcaster, even though we never see it in this game mode. Applying my ability. Weapon synthesis, seems so she can fuse armor knight soul with my short sword, a wog with my cutlass, my claymore, armor knight with my spear. Not right now. Although I will break these lights. And it's some light in here, so I'm going to go. Welcome, what do you think? Not a bad shop. Don't be cheap, Yoko's in the area. Da 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 da. She's here to investigate. He's motivated. Buy something. Potion. Nah. You only use. Oh yeah, there's some special monsters. They appear when you do certain fulfill certain conditions, and the UMA news tells you about them. Knife, rapier, short sword, claymore, spear, mace, axe. Yeah. does the most damage now, and the soul upgrades to the most powerful weapon in the game, the Death Soul. But that won't happen for quite a long time. On the map, this area is referred to as a village, and in the game sound files. But there's no actual villages here, they're just zombies. And possess favors. There's some stuff I can only access is one of the later bosses. Alright, one thing I can access now, which I'll do so before I move on. You see that over there? I can only get through there once I've beaten Paranoia. Look, it's a poster advertising the course. I assume that's what it is. It is one of those books. Annoyingly, when you level up, it doesn't restore your magic. So, you have to either wait for it to regen naturally or smash on that. We're now pretty much right below where we met Julius and Yoko. All the water goes somewhere. To a new area, the wizardry lab? Yeah. A place of never ending villages. There yet? That's the bowel, so I need to save room. Thank you. bomber arm says toss a powerful explosive. It's not actually all that powerful an explosive. With a soul, you can collect up to 9 of them. In some cases, the more you collect, the better their effects are, and they level up. For example, on my second skeleton, once I get 3, and 4, they level up. And it's a bigger bow, and then when it levels up again, same with the axe arm. There's actually a few where they level up in the something much more useful. Like the later skeleton. Because what he gives you the ability to do is throw a throw. Yeah. In the main village area. Yeah, that's most good. That and the water world, yeah, that's the other water world. It was closed off when we got there because there were no other water worlds. If I've used a glitch to get over that barrier that was here, then good, that's all. And we'd have been able to get to the wizard lab much earlier. Guys are enjoying, and I'll see you next time. Hold on.